Welcome to a lesson on proportions. A proportion is formed by setting two equivalent rates or ratios equal to each other. Looking toward the bottom of the screen, because the ratio of 2 to 3 is equivalent to the ratio of 4 to 6, this is a proportion. We can also say this is a proportion because the fractions 2/3 and 4/6 are equivalent. An important property about a proportion is that the cross products are always equal. Here the cross products are 2 times 6 and 3 times 4. Notice 2 times 6 equals 12, and so does 3 times 4. This is an important property because if we're missing one of these four values, we can use cross products to determine the missing value. In this first question, we're asked to use the given numbers and create a proportion. So to create a proportion, we want to use these numbers to form two equivalent fractions or ratios and set them equal to each other. Well, the fraction of 5/15 is equivalent to the fraction of 9/27, or we can say the ratio of 5 to 15 is equivalent to the ratio of 9 to 27. To verify this is a proportion, let's check the cross products. 5 times 27 equals 135, and so does 15 times 9, verifying this is set up correctly. There are several other proportions we can set up using these four values. If these ratios or fractions are equivalent, we could also write this as 15/5, or the ratio of 15 to 5 equals 27/9, or the ratio of 27 to 9. Notice how we still have the same cross products. We have 15 times 9 and 5 times 27, both equal 135. In our next example, we're given the values of 16, 4, 8, and 2. Well, 2/8 is equivalent to 4/16, or the ratio of 2 to 8 is equivalent to the ratio of 4 to 16, and therefore one proportion would be 2/8 equals 4/16, or the ratio of 2 to 8 equals the ratio of 4 to 16. Checking our cross products, 2 times 6 equals 32, and so does 8 times 4, verifying a proportion is correct. Another way to set this up would be to write the ratio of 8 to 2, or 8/2, equals the ratio of 16 to 4, or 16/4. Again, notice how both cross products are equal to 32. Here we're asked to solve the given proportions. To solve them, we will cross multiply and solve for the unknown. Looking at the first proportion, the cross products are 4 times x and 10 times 32. Well, 4 times x is equal to 4x, so 4x must equal 10 times 32 is equal to 320. Because 4x means 4 times x, to solve this equation for x, we divide both sides by 4. 4 divided by 4 simplifies to 1. 1 times x is x, so we have x equals 320 divided by 4, which equals 80. Our solution is x equals 80. In the next proportion, one cross product is k times 10, or 10k. The other cross product is 3 times 90, which equals 270. So cross multiplying gives us the equation 10k equals 270. To solve for k, we divide both sides by 10. 10 divided by 10 simplifies to 1. 1 times k is k. On the right side, 270 divided by 10 equals 27. Now let's look at two application problems. A car can travel 435 miles on 15 gallons of gas. How far can it travel on 3 gallons? We will solve this using a proportion by setting two rates equal to each other. So one rate is going to be 435 miles per 15 gallons of gas. So we have 435 miles per 15 gallons must equal the ratio of an unknown number of miles to 3 gallons. So we'll say x miles per 3 gallons. And now let's cross multiply and solve for x. Let's find the cross product with the variable first. So here we'll have 15 times x, which is 15x, equals 435 times 3, which equals 1,305. To solve for x, we divide both sides by 15. On the left, 15 divided by 15 simplifies to 1. 1 times x is x. X equals 1,305 divided by 15, which equals 87. Which means the car can travel 87 miles on 3 gallons of gas. For F, a car travels 234 kilometers in 3 hours with a constant speed. How much time will it take to travel 459 kilometers? Let's set up a proportion using the rates of kilometers per hour. So the first rate is 234 kilometers per 3 hours. The second rate is 459 kilometers per an unknown number of hours, let's say x hours. And now we cross multiply. One cross product is 234 times x, which is 234x. This must equal the other cross product of 3 times 459, which equals 1,377. Solve for x, we divide both sides by 234. Simplifying on the left, we have 1x, or x, equals 1,377 divided by 234, which comes out to a messy decimal. Rounding to the tenths place value, x is approximately 5.9. It will take approximately 5.9 hours to travel 459 kilometers. I hope you found this helpful.